Welcome to the Flying Circus of Physics. I'm Jearl Walker. I'm one of the physics professors here at Cleveland State University. Oh, you probably can't understand what I'm saying. Let me take this off.
I don't think I need this anyway. Today I'm going to talk to you about ionizing radiation. It is all around you, sources of ionizing radiation. That is, radiation that can strip electrons off atoms and molecules. We have ionizing radiation producing electrons, which are negatively charged, protons, which are positively charged, the antiparticles to electrons, the positrons, positively charged, alpha particles, which are bundles of two protons and two neutrons. Neutrons are neutral, but you got two protons there, so it's positively charged. When ionizing radiation goes through the gas that's inside this Geiger counter, we will get a burst of electrons inside, current, and that will cause a click in this instrument. Where's that radiation coming from? Well, it could be coming from the sun. We're getting protons from the sun, from the core of the sun, because of nuclear reactions. The ionizing radiation could be coming from other parts of the Milky Way, our Milky Way. The ionizing radiation could be coming from the cinder blocks here. In fact, it's hard to get away from ionizing radiation, but normally it's just too low a level to worry about. Almost anything that's grown in the ground, or on a plant that's growing in the ground, is slightly radioactive. For example, bananas have potassium 40 inside. But I'm not getting any real clicks here. I'm still just hearing the cosmic rays, the stuff coming from the sun and the Milky Way here, are from the cinder blocks there. We have some sources that we used to use in labs here at CSU. This is a cesium. Ooh, boy, a lot of clicks. I almost danced to that. This is a cesium source. It's got a half-life of 28 years. That means half of its activity goes away every 28 years. Well, this source is at least 48 years old, so it was weak to begin with. It's really weak now. Strontium. This is a beta emitter. That means it sends out electrons. And that's pretty active too. But again, this is 48 years old at least, so its activity has really dropped. One more item. It's a teacup. What could be dangerous about a teacup? This was made by a company called Fiestaware in the 1930s, and they used uranium oxide for the glaze here. That seals it up. I'm not too worried about uranium oxide. Uranium emits alpha particles. They get stopped by my skin or a piece of paper. Oh boy, this is really hot. And that uranium lasts almost forever. The Fiestaware were making saucers and dishes of all kinds up until the start of World War II. And then the government decided they needed the uranium. So they confiscated the entire stockpile. Hey, if you ever want a cup of hot tea, this is the thing to use. It'd be hot in both senses of the word. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you again here next time on the Flying Circus of Physics. Just remember, physics is everywhere, even in old dishware.